Tell me about Chamsi.
Well, it's a little bird. You want the story about when I first saw it, knew that it was something that people actually ate? Is that what you want?
What happened was in 1996, I saw a street cart selling this skewered stuff. And I saw that and I said, wow, like that's a thing, man. That's like a little, I don't know, alien bird. So I stopped and I looked at it for a little while, just at a distance. And I thought, I really want to eat that, but I don't have money. And so unfortunately, you know, when you don't have money, you always put things off to the future because you have no choice. So I always thought that forever, this little Bojang Matcha would be there and I would be able to come back and get in great victory with a full wallet, a little bit of Chamsi Gui. But I never did, it disappeared.
Ah, 근데 질문 있습니다. 저기 여기 머리까지 다 먹어요?
다 드시는 거예요. 버리는 거 하나도 없어요.
아, 그래요?
참새도 그렇고 메추리도 네. 뼈랑 다 드셔야 돼.
몇 가지요?
네.
알겠습니다. Yes, you're seeing little birdie heads.
Yeah. So that's the head.
So she just.
And she said, eat the head.
She says, yes, she eat everything. These bones are easier to eat. These bones aren't as easy to eat, but she said, eat everything. So it's going to be bones and head and all. Yeah.
So, Chamsi Mechuri, it looks like more bone than meat. And it's probably about 25% head. And when you say it looks like some kind of alien, I can't unsee that now. It's like a dragon alien thing. I can almost imagine why this is like not as popular as it used to be.
Yeah, the kids these days, they like their food to be sanitized, but that's good eating, man. So you're just delaying eating it, aren't you?
I didn't expect it to throw me this. I thought, it's gonna be like chicken or something, but it's, Okay,
so. Ready? Yeah. Just think of it as a meat popsicle.
Okay.
With the little meat popsicle top.
Okay. Oh, he went straight for the head.
Oh, because the head was on the top. Hmm. You know, we have an expression in English called bird brain.
Yes.
Yeah, like this person. I think it just means soft and squishy.
Oh gosh. I'm sweating. Bit of salt.
Yeah.
I might just go all in.
The whole thing?
Oh, man, I've got salt on his head.
It's on the head.
Okay.
Yeah, she's right. The bones are.
Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh.
That's really good. Yeah?
That is phenomenal. Yes. Wow. That tastes just like chicken.
And the bones give it the right amount of crunch. It's really good.
Oh my gosh.
I'm pretty surprised. Okay, so good call.
Oh my gosh.
It's literally like a perfect, with a bit of salt, it's literally like a perfect kind of street food.
Yeah.
Well, maybe even the perfect Anju.
I'm very impressed with this. This was worth the wait. Thank you for asking me. I'm eating my next one. I'm coming back here. All right, my young friend. Are you ready for the slightly bigger bird with the slightly chewier bones? I think she said to cut it into quarters.
Yep.
And yeah, that bone's got a little bit more of a pushback on it. Ooh, look at that. Who needs Kentucky Fried Chicken? Okay.
Oh, this looks amazing. Look at the meat on that. You see that?
Oh yeah, man, that bird worked out.
After you.
All right. Now those bones have a crunch. Wow. Chew it, like make sure you chew it so you don't get a bone stuck in your craw. No, you chew that too.
Throw that away.
Oh. See, that is not bad.
Korean has all these chicken places everywhere. I don't know why, man. We should just have pheasant places. Pheasant and chamsae.
Oh my gosh, that is phenomenal.
Do you feel just a little bit of spice on there?
Yes.
Yeah. And yeah, there, see? She's wiping that on there. So it must be something a little bit spicy or oily or something.
That is phenomenal.
Okay, so we had a leg, so let's go for the breast part now.
When she, the lady said it's a little bit more chewy, it's true, but it's not to the point where you can't eat it.
Mm.
Yeah. It's like continually flavorsome.
I would say it's similar to crispy pork skin.
Mmm, interesting. Yeah.
Not in terms of flavor, but in terms of the chewiness.
Both. You'd expect them to taste relatively similar, but maybe because it's got a little bit more fat, a little bit more meat to it, that it kind of retains that kind of more meatier taste. So happy. I'm so happy I come to know this. I think like this feels a bit like, I don't want to say life-changing, but it's shocked me how much I've enjoyed this.
Well, yeah, that's the reason we try new things, right? But are you ready for that one?
So what is this?
Take a smell.
Is it, it's just a berry, is it, or?
Kinda. You will notice this most in Seoul on the streets in the fall. Okay. When all of those orange ginkgos, nuckleberries fell down.
Oh, it's the smelly ones.
Yeah, yeah.
This is what this is?
Yeah, yeah.
You can eat these?
Yeah, but.
This is the smelly ones?
Kinda.
Okay.
So you know when you step on those ginkgo berries and everybody complains because it smells and they say this is on my shoe now?
Yes.
I like the way it feels when they crunch.
Okay.
This is the part that pops in the middle. This is the berry that's in the inside of it.
Ah, interesting.
And they do something to it, don't ask me what, but through whatever process, and then they put them on a stick and you eat them.
So cool.
However, I have heard from very reputable sources that if you eat too many of these, you're not going to be leaving the toilet for a while.
Oh.
They have 5 on this stick. I'm thinking maybe we don't want to eat more than 5.
Okay, I'm going to try 2.
Amateur.
Oh, you're going to try 1?
No, I'm going to go through all of them.
You're going to eat them all, but you're going to eat them slowly.
I'm just going to say, That's not bad, huh? Really strong aftertaste. Can you taste the aftertaste?
Wow. It's not the aftertaste tastes like.
It's bitter.
It's bitter. It tastes like my climbing shoes smell. Because you can't not smell them when there's an earthiness to it. It's not bad.
It's not bad.
Not bad. It's very bitter.
Yeah.
I feel like I'm going through like a whole kind of range of tastes that I don't think I was quite ready for. My brain's kind of like, I really enjoyed this. Definitely gonna have this again.
Yeah.
Thoroughly enjoyed this. Definitely gonna have this again. This is a little Anju. As a little Pantan, yep. Like kind of comes out of service. Great.
I wanted to tell you a couple of stories about this area.
Yeah.
That's all. That's cool.
Please, yeah.
So before all these fancy new buildings were here, we used to have behind us here on Chongmyo, there used to be Pimakko. It's still there. Like Pimakko is like hidden alley, I think. And it would go from Kwanghwamun all the way down to, as the old people would say, Chongsam. As the young people say, Chongno Samga. They're more sophisticated. And it was a great place because it had all kinds of little cheap places to eat. It was wonderful. I was eating at a restaurant there in early 2000s, perhaps. And I remember this old guy, he was sitting there and he looked at me. And he asked me in English, his English was quite good. Can I ask you a question? And I said, sure. And he said, why are you eating that? And I was kind of puzzled, right? Like, that's an odd question. Why am I eating that? I said, because it's Donchang Chigae. And he said, but for the same price, you could eat at McDonald's. So why are you eating that here? And I said, well, I came to Korea to experience the culture. And I had nothing against McDonald's. I'm not anti-capitalist or anything. But what would be the point? I can have this for, I think, I don't know, 2,500, 3,000 won or whatever it was at that time.
Wow.
And he looked at me and he gave me the old person nod of approval.
I love that.
That was just back here. Yeah, they had the really nice godang
Yeah.
over the fire. They used to have that all through here. That was amazing.
Yeah.
In fact, ever been to a PC bar?
Yeah, of course.
You just assume they're everywhere.
Right.
There used to be exactly one, it wasn't a PC bar, internet cafe, and it was over there.
Really?
Yeah. That was before they, again, before they ripped all down the old buildings and stuff. It was up on the second floor. It was called Net Cafe. Well, there was a time when I was at 100% of the Starbucks in Seoul.
Because there was one.
Because there was one. Yeah, cheers.
Oh. It got really hard.
Yeah, they firm up a little bit. Oh, you can use that for a toothpick.
It's so incredibly satisfying when you get through it, though.
Mm-hmm.
You think, is this going to break my teeth? Is this going to break my teeth? And then you're through and you're like,
oh, it's a wonderful crunch.
Mm.